Go to the judges, they get one save. Will you use your one save this season on Heejun?
Unfortunately, after talking, we're gonna have to let you go, man.
We'll miss you and your flavor on this show.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your judges, Randy Jackson, Jennifer Lopez, and Steven Tyler. And your host, Ryan Seacrest.
Coming to you live from Hollywood. Tonight, your top eight are bringing music that is sure to send some of you straight back to your high school prom, because over the next 2 hours, we're paying tribute to the decade that brought us The Miracle on Ice, Stonewashed Jeans, and Neon Tube Socks. Of course, I'm talking about the 80s. To set the tone, here is what a typical aspiring fashionista would have looked like back then.
Ryan, that was fly for the time, though, dude. That was so fly.
You actually said to yourself, yeah, I'm going out like this.
It's a stage look, man.
You've certainly come a long way.
Oh, no.
Ish. Let's bring out your top eight, America. Here we go. So not only is this group singing their individual selections, but they're gonna be paired up in guy-girl duets. And to help mentor, Jimmy Iovine brought in two members of No Doubt, Gwen Stefani and bassist Tony Kanal. So we're excited about that. The contestants are also gonna be sharing what they miss most from home. Could you do a shiatsu?
Yeah.
And for DeAndre, it's something every teenager just loves to do. Here we go.
I really miss my car. I miss driving so much. You know how it is. I just got my license before I did Idol, you know, and I didn't really have that much time to drive around by myself, get that freedom, you know, the independence.
They let me borrow the car today. Can't wait to go for a ride.
I just love driving, you know. Just, it doesn't matter where I'm going. I just drive in circles. I'm about to go to the studio. Jimmy, where's your studio at? I can't find it.
What are you thinking about?
Well, I'm thinking about Gwen right now.
There you go.
This week, I'm singing the 80s song, I Like It by DeBarge.
I feel like sometimes you look really worried the whole time, and I think you should just be more confident, like, own it.
DeAndre is the full package, but I always notice he'll sing a song, and then right afterward, he'll be like, even if he feels that way, he should be like, what's up? Did you just hear that? You know what I mean?
Part of being great is conquering nervous. No one gets more nervous than this one before she goes on stage.
Really?
But yes.
No, you don't.
But you don't notice it.
Oh. I get more nervous when I come to you, actually.
Well, that's...
Yeah, I get really nervous. I'm only 17. But after every performance, I feel great about myself. I just need to show it.
You're going to be great. It's going to be amazing.
Overcoming fear, letting the fear get you. It's really going to come down to that. Because if he gets nervous, he's not going to be able to pull it off. I think he's in the bottom three.
Thinking about you for quite a while. You're on my mind every day and every night. My every thought is you. The things you do, yes, I'm so satisfied.
Super comfortable up there. I feel like you took what they told you to heart. You were really enjoying the crowd. You know, even in the way you moved your hair this time, you know, because I know you're about your hair. But even in that, I felt like it was all very natural and you had the crowd going. You sounded amazing. You did some beautiful things in there, really made it your own. Great start to the show. Great job.
Yonder, man, totally captivating. I forgot where I was. I forgot where I was. And you took your voice, the way you used to play with it, we thought was a little bit too much, and you've owned it, man. You've become who you are, and you wore it well today. That was exceptional today.
Yo, man, El DeBarge is somewhere, who's the lead singer of DeBarge. He's somewhere saying, oh my God, this kid has arrived. Mm-hmm. You know what I love is that you use more of your natural voice, not just all falsetto. So if you continue to do that, beautiful, play with your natural, then go into the false for like the runs and stuff. It was perfect. It's the perfect kind of song for you. I would make records like this, and you could be a newer 2012 version of DeBarge, dude. It was amazing. One of my best performances for you.
DeAndre, ladies and gentlemen.
Nice work, my man. So, I'm always interested to get the take of a contestant about going first. What do you think about opening the show?
Well, it's a double-edged sword. You know, I don't want to be forgotten, but, you know, I just got to bring it, and hopefully
It was the dull edge tonight, meaning good, right?
Yes,
not the sharp
good.
Edge.
No, not the sharp edge, no, no. I was comfortable, and I know I brought it, you know, so hopefully everybody else thinks that
well,
way.
Well, if you like DeAndre and his...
No.
It's been a long day, Mike.
No Hollywood,
a little
Ryan.
Rough.
You warm up a little bit.
No Hollywood, Ryan. No Hollywood to you.
1-866-8001. 1-866-436-5701. If you're with AT&T, you can text the word vote to 5701. You can also vote online at AmericanIdol.com. Lines open at the end of the show and will stay open for at least 2 hours. They're 866 numbers, not 800, so please dial carefully. DeAndre America, thank you. After this, Elise tries to continue her hot streak with the number one smash from Foreigner. Live next. Show. Tonight, our top eight are all about the 80s, which means a huge selection of music. And if you want them in your library, download the songs online. I made that. Thank you for holding my sign, including this one from Elise.
I miss Charleston. I especially miss my band. We used to rock it out. My band members are always cheering me on and giving me advice, and they are just so excited about it, but I know that they miss me a lot, so it's bittersweet. I've learned so much just by being in that band. This really molded me into a well-rounded musician.
What are you thinking about?
Oh, man, it was tough. I was going back and forth between a million songs.
Yeah.
I picked out Hallelujah by Leonard Cohen.
This is sick.
Thank you.
You wanted to try another song. What was it?
Foreigner, I Want to Know What Love Is.
I love that song.
Yeah.
Okay, let's hear it.
I want to feel what love is. Oh.
We both had goosebumps, if that means anything. Yeah, for sure.
They're called goosies on the show.
Oh, they are?
Yeah.
Sorry.
I think this is probably the right thing to do this week.
I think that explosive chorus, that drama is just, you know, it's so you, but it's also so 80s and it's so emotional for people. She actually is one of my favorite singers in the whole contest. Fingers crossed for you right here. I definitely think that this Foreigner song could be a magic moment for her.
I'm gonna take a little time, a little time to think things over. Now this mountain I must climb feels like the world upon my shoulders. In my life there's been a heartache and pain, and I don't know if I can face it again. I can't stop now. I've traveled so far to change. Take a little time, a little time to look around me.
I'm not sure if that song was the right song for you tonight, baby. But I love your voice. It's hard to take one from the other because it's an 80s song, and that's for sure. And 80s songs are 80s songs, but yeah.
Mm. Elise, you look beautiful tonight.
Yeah.
So beautiful. I love the way your look is developing over the show. You have a powerhouse voice, which means you can sing anything. Mm-hmm. You know, I think what they heard is that it wasn't totally right every single moment, and that's all it was, but you still sounded beautiful to me, and I felt your emotion, and I felt how much heart you put into it, and it was a really great performance on that level.
For me, it's a tough thing. It's a tough song to sing. It's one of the greatest songs ever. One of my favorites. And what technically happened for you, you never quite hit the pitch right. So it was pitchy the whole song until the very end because you were just underneath the pitch every time. And with these kinds of songs, this is to help her. It was not your greatest performance. I think you're much better than this. But to help you, it's the easy things when you're a singer, as great as you are, with as much stuff as you can do with the runs, it's the easy, simple notes in the verse. Sometimes you just have to let it lay there and not sing any runs and concentrate more on the pitch where it lands. It was just out of tune everywhere for me, honestly.
Elise Testone. All right, some tough feedback. Last week, you had such a strong week, and I know that you were considering... You want to do that again?
Yeah.
Boop, boop. I know that you were considering a lot of songs.
Yeah.
How many were
it
you
was
looking
hard.
At?
I could not decide. Like, I felt really good about last week, so I was like, man, I can't, you know, it's so hard to follow that up, you know? So I wanted to pick, like, the perfect song, and I, like, just thought about it so much.
What was the deciding factor for that song?
Because I wanted to do more of a ballad since it was such a rock song last week, but I didn't want to lose the rock element of the song. So that's why I kind of steered away from Hallelujah. Even though, I mean, I love that song too. It was hard. There's so many great songs, you know?
Well, you are tremendously talented and you have a lot of fans. If you want to vote for Elise, 1-866-436-5702, or you can text the word vote to 5702. Calls are toll-free from landlines and standard. Text rates may apply. You can also vote online at AmericanIdol.com. Elise Testone. On the other side, it's our first duet of the evening. Colton and Skylar do Dolly and Kenny live. Idol next. Live on Idol. Tonight we're going back to the 80s, and don't forget, let us know what you think on Twitter as you watch. Next up, with a 1983 country smash, Islands in the Stream, put your hands together for Colton Dixon and Skylar Lane.
Baby, when I met you, there was peace unknown. I set out to get you with a fine-tooth comb. I was soft inside. There was something going on. You do something to me that I can't explain. Hold me closer and I feel
I saw what song you guys were singing. I was like, well, that's going to be definitely interesting for Colton.
Yeah.
Not quite in your wheelhouse, but you know what? Listen, you guys did a really good job. It was very sweet and very nice, and I know there's a lot of lyrics and melody in there, but I'm telling you what, Skylar, you sounded beautiful. Colton, you sounded great, man. Very nice. I enjoyed that. I actually enjoyed that line. I love that.
Skylar, it was just perfect for you. What I love is you know exactly when to bite into a song. You don't overdo it. You just give it to us right when we need it. Colton, even though it was a departure for you, you were the perfect partner for her for this. It was beautiful. I really enjoyed it, too.
Match made in heaven. Perfect, beautiful harmony. Just shows as well your individuality as great artists. So that was beautiful.
Nice.
Oh, no. I have to say, very believable watching that performance.
Here we go.
The chemistry here. Let's hear for Colton Skylar, ladies and gentlemen. Just after this, our Georgia native also takes on a mega hit from 83. Philip goes with Genesis next.
On Twitter if me and Colton are dating, and then Ryan says that no, me and Colton are not dating.
We're not?
Shut up, Colton.
I'm just kidding.
We are just really good friends, my buddy.
Great friends.
So that clears that up.
You're locked live on Idol. Last week we announced the return of Coca-Cola's Perfect Harmony program, the songwriting collaboration that gives you an opportunity to help create a new hit song. It's called Undefeated. You'll see it performed live on our finale. Already we've received thousands of lyrics to help Jason Derulo finish his song. And now it's time for you to pick your favorite out of this week's top three entries. So hit up AmericanIdol.com and check it all out. Next up is Philip Phillips. Let's do it.
This is my brother-in-law, Ben Neal, on the guitar.
What I miss about Leesburg, Georgia is jamming with my brother-in-law, Ben. He's taught me a lot about music. He's made me a better musician than I am. He's always pushed me to make it try to sound even better. When we play together, I can listen to his note, what he's hitting, and I know what I need to do. It's really awesome how we have that connection. I don't really see it too often. If Ben got to play on the stage with me, I'd be grinning from ear to ear. So I'm gonna do That's All by Genesis.
When we heard that Philip was gonna do that song, we were like, oh, that's perfect for him. He's gonna kill it. I mean, we're huge fans. But he seemed like, okay, guys, you know, I'm not ready to do this, actually, and he wasn't.
Tell me it's black when I know he is white. Oh, it's the same as the chain that's song.
But you could see through it. You could see he was going to get there.
I would make one suggestion on that bridge. What if you don't play guitar? I mean, you still have your guitar on, but let it go.
Yeah.
Make eye contact maybe with a camera or somebody in the audience. It seemed like there needed to be a more intimate moment in the song. So when he stopped playing guitar on the bridge and he has a chance to connect with the audience, I think that's going to be a big deal for him.
Truth is I love you.
When he broke it down and stopped, it was very sexy. I think he'll definitely make it this week, and I think he's going to be in the top tops.
Just
just as I thought it was going all right. Found it wrong when I thought it was right. It's always the same, it's just a shame, that's all. I can say day, you say night. Tell me it's black when I know that it's white. It's always the same, it's just a shame, that's all. I could leave, but I won't go. Though my heart might tell me so. I can't feel a thing from my head down to my toe. So why does it always seem to be me looking at you, you looking at me? It's always the same, it's just a shame, and that's all. It's hurting me, oh, it's hurting me off. Making me feel like I want too much. Living with you just putting me through it all of the time. Running around, staying out all night. Taking it all instead of taking one bite. Living with you just putting me through it all of the time. You looking at me, I'll do the same. It's just a shame, and that's all. But I love you more than I wanted to. There's no point in trying to pretend. There is no one who makes me feel like you do. Say we'll be together till the end. Tell me it's black when I know that it's white. Living with you just sound the same, and that's all.
Flower, aren't you? I love your individuality. I love you brought your bro up here, and I love the way he sang those notes along with you, man. You just love being who you are, you know? And that transcends, and that's making you great every time I hear you, man. Yeah. You keep that up.
You know how much I love you. I felt like the beginning of it felt like you weren't all the way in your comfort zone. I don't know if your brother was plays loud, and you were trying to find it for a second, but then towards the end, you picked it up, and you brought it home, and you were the Philip that we love. So I don't really have much else to say then. That was pretty great.
Yo. Well, listen, you know I'm a huge fan, and what's brother's name?
Ben.
Yo, what's
Neil.
Up, man? What's going down? I like the... I love the whole brotherly love thing. I could sense your comfort one time. He looked at you and smiled. I'm like, yo, these boys have done this before. Look, I loved it. I mean, I thought it was a great song choice for you. And by the way, as the mentors go, Tony Kanal, big ups and big props to you, because
the great
note about not playing the guitar on the bridge was brilliant, because it let the song breathe the way that it should. I thought it was great, man. Another great performance. And bro, man, you should be up here with it.
Come on over here. So I just want to, I got to get your take on watching Philip back home, knowing that you've inspired him to play the guitar and seen him compete on American Idol.
It's definitely crazy, but I couldn't be more proud of him. Staying true to himself, we all rooting for him back home.
You probably couldn't hear it at home, but in the studio you could hear the girls go, aww. To vote for Philip, 1-866-IDOL-03, 1-866-436-5703, or you can text and vote to 5703. Ben, Philip, thank you very much. On the other side, Holly and DeAndre team up for some Pointer Sisters. Prepare to party right after this. All right, man. Welcome back to to American Idol. We are taking things back to the 80s tonight. And up next, we're being treated to one of the decade's most recognizable hits with the Pointer Sisters. I'm so excited. Holly and DeAndre.
Beautiful. And Holly, man, I like that you let go a little bit. That's what you need to do. You need to get so excited, okay? That was great. Both of you guys, beautiful.
You know, I gotta say, when I heard you were gonna sing, I'm so excited. I was like, oh, I don't know about that. You know what I mean? But it was. I'd like to see you. I saw your little moves. I'm sure Nappy Tabs had a little bit to do with that. Give me a little bit of movement here and there. Holly, I thought that was really good. And that's what he's right. You need to do more of that. You really need to let go, find the soul in everything that you're doing so that you can really match what you do with your vocals, which is amazing. And it was amazing on this. DeAndre, you look right at home. Sounded great. Together, you guys sounded great. Good job.
Very, 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 very nice from two youngins. I love it, man. Listen, I like when you started doing the ad-libs, DeAndre, and Holly, see that power you brought in at the end? You felt like just free and you were flowing. You got that because you guys can both really sing. Very nice. Very impressive.
So how is your comfort level different when you're singing a song that's technically not judged? It's a little bit more for fun.
I feel like it's more fun because you don't have to worry, you know? You can just kind of, you know, and like you feed off the other person that you're singing with,
the
too,
energy.
So, yeah.
How about for you, DeAndre?
Same, same, but you know, I have fun no matter what.
Ditto. All right, let's hear it for Holly and DeAndre. Just after this, Joshua takes on Simply Red, plus we go upbeat with the Whitney dance classic, but will it come to you from Jessica Sanchez or her alter ego, BB Chez? Find out next. Welcome back to American Idol. I'm just reading Steven's notes, most of which I cannot read to you on live television.
Exactly.
Please don't.
I will not.
Guys on the button right now like this. All right, so we're down to 8 contestants. Just checking in with you. You're being very positive tonight. Do you feel like everyone's up their game? Do you like the music? Just want to get your feedback, Steven.
I think they're doing the best they can with up in their game. The 80s wasn't so good for me with music, partially because I wasn't really all there for it. I was other places at the time. they're doing the best they can. I'm always a little estranged by the fact that if they don't pick the right song, because I love their voices for what they do. If they can step outside of that, then they're winners.
Jen?
I think for me, DeAndre's standing out tonight, you know? I do. He started the show off really, really strong. It was a perfect song for him. He did great in his duet, and he's kind of like a little shining star for me tonight.
Steven mentioned song selection. What is the best advice to a contestant that is new to this when it comes to picking the right song?
You know, for me, I mean, you saw what DeAndre did. Jennifer's right. I mean, he's standing out so far against some of the others. The duets are nice and cute, too, but the problem is you got to sing the I don't know what out of whatever the song is. I keep hearing people talk about the songs. Hey, if you sing it great, it won't even matter.
All right, we need some powerhouse.
We need some juice in here right now. Who's Ryan? You know what I want to know? Who's got to have it? Ryan, do you have to have it?
Subtlety, Randy Jackson. The race is on to the finale, and everyone is truly feeling the pressure, especially Joshua.
I can't feel it anymore. Last week, my emotions came out on stage because I was missing my family. It's just tough being all the way here by myself. I'm the youngest child, and I'm spoiled a little bit.
Josh always got away with everything. He's definitely the baby of the family.
They spoiled me a little too much because I don't really want to do nothing but sing.
We love you, Josh.
This week I'm singing If You Don't Know Me By Now by Simply Red.
If you don't know.
He's obviously has incredible vocal gymnastics. I mean, it's just insane what he can do with his voice.
If you don't know me.
Sometimes I think it can be too much.
What do you think of the key change?
Well, I mean, it showcases his unbelievable thing that he does right there.
Just, we gotta get back into the song in the right way.
This arrangement is kind of challenging. It kind of wasn't going the right direction.
It needs to be just simpler when it comes back into the hook.
Jimmy told them to just drop the band out and then come in after me. And I think it's genius.
If you don't know me by now.
The song that he chose is really, really good for him.
Once the break was put in the song, I think it worked a lot better.
Yeah.
It was so comfortable, and it just felt so, it was the right thing to do.
I know what I'm gonna do. Outside the show that night, I'm gonna sell Holy Ghost t-shirts. We're gonna make a fortune. The minute you hit that note, I get everybody on the street, $5 a piece. Every note of that song he sang, I felt it. So I'm with him on it 100%. I just think he's there, and he stays.
That we've been through, you should understand me like I understand you. Girl, I know the difference between right and wrong. I ain't gonna do nothing to upset our happy home. Don't get so excited when I come home a little late at night, 'cause we only act like children when we argue, fuss, and fight. If you don't know me by now, you will never know me. Just get yourself together. If you don't
crazy.
Ask and seek and you shall receive. That's what they say, right?
Yo.
Lordy.
Ask and ye shall receive. That's what they say. We asked for a powerhouse performance, and that's what we got.
Yo.
Wow! Joshua, you know what I love so much? In the beginning, you came out, and you held back, and I could feel you holding back, but you were also so comfortable. It was such a beautiful thing to watch, because I was like, oh, he's going to let loose on us in a minute. And you did, and it was spectacular.
Over the top, man. Outstanding. Joshua, how can someone sing like you at your age?
Oh,
it's unreal.
So good.
You know, what a perfect, beautiful song. And the choir just nestled you. They sing the chorus, and then you just sat right into it. And again, use your natural voice, and it wasn't too much over the top, and it was way over the top. So it was just perfect.
Thank you.
You're great, man. You are a great singer.
Yo, listen, it's very rare on this show. You see a stand-up at the end. It's very rare that I want to stand up from beginning to end. That's how good that performance was.
Great.
It was so mature, dude. You were so in your zone, and it's what I said to Ryan. I don't care what the song is, and that's a great song. But you sang it, dude. That's what it's about. You know what I think? Jennifer Stephen. Ryan. I think we found someone tonight who's got to have it, Ryan. Joshua's got to have it, America!
Joshua Legend! Great job! I keep waiting for you to say somebody's in it to win it.
No, do you got to have it? Do you got to have it, Ryan? Speaking of the Olympics,
we got to have it,
Ryan! We got to have it!
I mean, you took control of that song. You own that song. You were feeling that song. How emotionally draining is this process, week to week?
I mean, it's very tough. I mean, working 7 days a week. And just getting songs that you never heard before and trying to learn them and just adapting to them and making them mean so much to you when I don't know anything about the song because I'm only 19 years old, so I can't say I had any love problems. But
you could have fooled us.
Yeah, but just trying to help somebody else that, so.
Well done. Joshua Ledeck. You want to vote for Joshua? 1-866-436-5704, or you can text the word vote to 5704. You can also vote online at AmericanIdol.com. Voting at the end of the show for at least 2 hours. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Okay, let's continue the music right now with our San Diego high schooler.
Before all this happened, I would consider myself a normal teenager. Boys and nails and, well, shopping, yes. And I miss all that. I used to sing in my room, in front of my mirror, and sing to boxes. And it's cool now that I can sing in front of people instead of boxes. This week I'm gonna be singing How Will I Know by Whitney Houston.
There's a boy I know.
Jessica is clearly shockingly good. It's crazy how young she is. One thing that I would say is your voice is ridiculous, but the way you move your body, try to do things that are maybe a little more unique as opposed to trying to do what's typical, like lounge singer style, like moves. Like
Beyonce has her alter ego, Sasha Fierce, and I have my alter ego, BB Chez. Last week I sang Sweet Dreams by Beyonce, and I think that really showed out the different side of me, my alter ego, and I want to show that every week.
Your voice is already doing what you do naturally. Now your body needs to kind of follow.
Tonight you will see a lot of BB Chez. She's fun and she wants to just party all night, so BB Chez is coming out. Can I get a hug?
I want one.
Oh, yay.
She's gonna nail it. It's gonna be awesome.
There's a boy I know. He's what a dreamer. Looks into my eyes. Takes me to the clouds above. Oh, I love. Can't seem to get enough.
that's two powerhouse vocals in a row.
Right.
There we go. You know what, Jessica? I'd watch you sometimes up there. Your choices are so natural to you. You're such a natural performer. And I look at you, you're such a little girl, but there's like this woman up there at the same time. It's crazy. Yeah. It's such a combination for me to watch. But it's so amazing. Your vocals just make everything just go away for me. I'm listening to you, and I can't even believe it's coming out of that little body.
I'm saying it. I'm saying
this is crazy. Really, really good. Really good performance. You moved around. You kept it moving. The audience was with you. It was good.
I gotta agree. I don't think I've ever heard you sing where I can judge you. Your voice is so fantastic.
Yeah.
I just gotta say, everything you do is beautiful. Thank everything you. You do is great.
Thank you.
You're great, girl.
Yo. So listen, song by the great Whitney Houston. I had the pleasure of working on that song. You did an amazing job because that's a big shoes to fill because she sings just so effortlessly. But that's what you just did. I mean, you just were walking. Dude, I'm telling you, I can't believe the maturity, man, in
you.
That's what Gwen was saying, the maturity. I mean, welcome. Ryan, she's got to have it too.
That have to have it. I mean, it is true. You watch the poise, the confidence that you have, the nuances in every beat of that performance, and you go, how old are you?
16.
You go, what?
Yeah.
Right?
She's lying.
Yeah.
She's
how
lying.
Is that true? It's incredible.
She's lying.
It's really incredible.
Ryan, some could say she's maybe an Olympic performer. Ryan, you're going to judge the Olympics, are you?
Interesting you mentioned that, Randy. If you'd like to vote for Jessica, the numbers are 1-866-IDOL-05, 1-866-436-5705, or you can text or vote to 5705. Don't do anything until the end of the show. Well done. Thank you very much, Jessica. Or BB.
BB.
On the other side, find out what happens when we take one part Philip, one part Elise, and mix in some Tom Petty. Plus three words. Holly, Flashdance Live, next on Idol. Welcome back to the hashtag Gotta Have It show. Thanks to Randy Jackson tonight. Naima, nice to see you, darling. And Mr. Fashion, Tommy, good to see you. Nice to have you with us. And boss, always a pleasure. Get a haircut. Tonight, our top eight, all about the 80s with their individual performances and some guy-girl duets, including this Tom Petty and Stevie Nicks classic. Stop Dragging My Heart Around, Philip and Elise.
Elise, welcome back, baby. That was hot. Yeah. You and Phil, that sounded amazing. Jennifer and I just looking at each other, she said, no, I want to hear more of that.
I want more of that show.
That was great. That was great. Very nice. Both of you, very nice.
When you hear duets and you like imagine you're the girl or you imagine you're the guy and you want to be the person and that they're talking to each other, that's what I felt like when you guys were singing. I was like, oh, I want to be that. Are they really in love? You know what
I mean?
No, you're not. But I'm just saying, you know, you get that feeling when you hear great music and it's sung that great. Thank you.
Nice.
Outstanding. A Tom Petty moment wrapped up in Elise and Philip. Couldn't have been better. And Philip, your vocal, where you went that, see that, see that, see that, that rhythm change in the middle of the song. I heard you, man.
Sick.
It's just, it was beautiful.
Sick.
It was nice. Just as good as it gets.
That was fun. I love the way Philip creeps around the stage, grabbing that jacket, feeling that song. That was fun to watch. Philip and Elise, ladies and gentlemen. Right now, let's check out what Holly misses the most. Take a look.
This is the first time I've been away from home for this long. I miss just family and friends and my puppy Shankly. When I left him, he was a little baby, and then my brother showed me a picture, and he was like, he's getting huge. So next time I see him, he's gonna jump on me and probably be the size of my whole body.
This is Holly.
Hi, I'm Holly.
Amazing Holly.
Nice to meet you.
I had no idea that our mentor was Gwen Stefani.
My heart just started beating really fast.
And I was like, oh God, like, what am I gonna do?
So, what are you gonna try, Holly?
This week, I'm singing What a Feeling from the movie Flashdance.
When I first heard this song, I thought it was the most corny song in the world, you know? As a matter of fact, I passed on the soundtrack.
What?
It was a very stupid mistake. So, now that I'm hearing the song in this context, you can feel it's got like that Rocky thing, you know? And when that second verse hits, let people know that you're feeling something.
The song is about confidence. It's about, you know what, you can knock me down, but you're not gonna knock me down. So I think when you're singing it, it's not like sad. It's more like tough, you know what I mean? Maybe bring that little edge into it a little bit.
I definitely thought the advice that Gwen gave me was right, because I was singing it kind of like I was feeling sorry for myself.
I think what you need to do is prepare, get in that moment, and then free fall.
Yeah.
Holly, at times, gets a little technical. This song's called What a Feeling, so she's got to bring nothing but feeling.
So we're back live, still setting up the stage, trying to get a little power here to the keyboard. Bear with us momentarily. No pressure. So I've noticed that you have gotten more and more comfortable. Steven said, have a little bit more fun. Can you attack that tonight?
I think so. I think it's time that I show, like, a different side other than just, like, singing a ballad and just kind of sing.
And you are having fun.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I was going to ask who you're wearing, but it looks like we're ready. Here she is, ladies and gentlemen. Take it away.
First, when there's nothing but a slow glowing dream, that your fear seems to hide deep inside your mind. All alone I have cried, silent tears full of pride, in no world made of steel.
Girl, you always arrive. Your songs are always great at the end. You always arrive. It took us a little slow getting there to this time, and your pitch was all over the place. I'm so sorry to tell you. You got there at the end, but it took a while to get there.
Here's the thing, baby. You're listening to what everybody's telling you, you know? And I see that. Go here, move here, do this, sing it this way, do that. At the end of the day, you do have to let it go. You know, it started off, it felt a little bit like, some of the notes felt like musical-like. It didn't feel like the pop song that it is. And then with the movement and everything, it just felt like you don't release, you don't let go. You have to forget what everybody tells you once you get up there. You know, you really do. What he said about free-falling, he's absolutely right. Yeah. You're smart. The smart thing to do is to listen to people, because these are people who know what they're talking about, been doing it for years. Okay, so you're doing that, and then when you get up here, let it go. That's the best advice somebody gave me a long time ago as well, and it works. Now you got to stop thinking. You got to get up there, and you got to just feel it from your heart, from your soul, and let it go. When you do that, that will match your vocal ability, the talent that you have in your voice, and it's going to be amazing.
And by the way, both Stephen and Jennifer are absolutely correct. You have the talent. That's why we say these things to you, because she's right. If you stop thinking, your voice is amazing. You hear those notes at the end. That's why Stephen said it started slow, but it finally got there in the end. And there were a couple of pitchy kind of moments, but I think it's always those times, those things happen to you when you're thinking and not just, you know, not just living it. You know what I mean?
Holly, ladies and gentlemen, so what do you make of that advice? Because I do know there are so many people with so many different things that they are trying to tell you and help you with. It is tough.
Yeah, I mean, I definitely agree, and I take everything that everyone says to me to, like, next performances, and I am still, like, landing with everything in the music industry, so, I mean, it's all an experience.
So don't listen to anything for the next few seconds. For Holly, 1-866-IDOL-06, 1-866-436-5706. Calls are toll-free from landlines. Standard text rates may apply. And lines open at the end of the show and will stay open for at least 2 hours. Thank you very much. Holly, good luck, guys. After the break, if you ever wondered what the matchup of Jessica and Joshua would sound like, you're in luck. They duet next. Back with you live here in Hollywood. Tonight, we're all about the 80s with our mentors Gwen Stefani and Tony Kanal from No Doubt. So let's move on to a duet now from our two soul singers with Aretha Franklin and George Michael's I Knew You Were Waiting For Me, Joshua and Jessica. Take it away.
I escaped. I found my way out of the darkness. Kept my faith. Kept my faith. The river was deep. I didn't falter. When the mountain was high, I still believed. When the valley was low, it didn't stop me. No, no. I knew you were waiting. I knew you were waiting for me.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Yo, let me just say this, man. Two of the greatest singers to ever hit this competition, both of you, yeah. Jessica and Joshua. I worked on that song, had the pleasure with Aretha and George Michael. Really? They sang it. You guys brought your own flavor to it. You both look fly. The styling is dope. This is one of the greatest performances to me. This is one of the greatest performances I've seen on this show. You guys are ready, man. Ryan, they definitely gotta have it.
It is.
I think they've got it.
I'm gonna give it to them if they don't get it.
It's a dream pairing, and I'm looking there, and I'm looking like, final?
Yeah,
maybe?
Dude, what's going on?
I don't know.
Yo, this is,
you never know. Listen. With all the great singers here, you don't know, but that was something amazing. You guys slayed that.
That performance was so over the top, it defies judging, only to be enjoyed. That was so fine.
Incredible energy. Incredible energy. Such a pleasure to watch. I saw you whisper something to Jessica just before we came back live. What did you say to her?
I can't remember.
It was something good because she smiled and basically hugged you. And
I said
you
she better rock out. I was going to be mad at her. No.
She rocked out and so did you. Thank you very much. That was terrific. When we come back, Colton puts his own twist on a Cyndi Lauper classic. Don't miss it live. It's Idol. Be right back. Choosing American Idol. I've got some assistants here this evening. Good to have you girls with us. How do you know each other? Cheerleading?
Cheerleading.
Let me see a herky. We've got 8 singers trying to win you over tonight, including the guy who left a very unique job back in Tennessee. Here we go, girls.
So this time of year, I'm normally working the Sky Cult face painting business, the family-owned business at the National Predator Games. They've earned a spot in the playoffs. The playoffs are the best to paint faces. I'm missing it. My family and my sister actually went back last weekend and painted one of the Preds games. I'm gonna have to catch back up on my skills. I'm losing them.
What are we trying, man?
I am gonna try time after time.
Okay.
So. It feels like every time we go into a writing session,
we put that song on
to try and see if we can write that song. That's the song, that's the song that you wish you wrote.
When I first heard he was gonna do it, I was like, that's a little strange, but then when he did it, it was great.
Well, I was noticing that's a very repetitive song without that bridge.
Right.
Maybe you break it down there.
Maybe at halftime?
That'd be great.
If you allow
That's great.
When Gwen Stefani sang harmony with me on my song, it sounded so much better than it normally did. It was amazing. I wanted so bad to ask her if she'd sing it with me live.
So let's do it again.
That sounds amazing.
Yeah, right. That's.
Yeah, it really did. It sounds
so much
better.
About me right now, okay?
No, but that big one's about him. He gets to sing with an incredibly beautiful girl.
Oh, Jimmy Jim.
I think Colton picked the right song this week. Flipping the gender on it, making it a male song, really works for me. I think that there's no way he's out this week.
Bet I hear the clock tick and think of you, caught up in circles. Confusion is nothing new. If you say go slow, I fall behind. The second turned away. If you're lost, you can look, you will find me. Time after time. If you fall, I will catch you. I'll be waiting. Time after time. Sometimes you picture me. I'm walking too far ahead. You're calling to me. I can't hear what you said. Now you say, go slow. I fall behind. Second tender winds. If you're lost, you can look and you will find it. Time after time. If you fall, I will catch you. I'll be waiting. Time after time. Now you say, go slow. I fall behind. But the drum beats out of time. You can lose, you can lose.
Ryan, you got one of those kind of voices that's so good, you could do a record right now, man.
Thank you.
Just proved what you could do to a good song, and you nailed it.
Thank you.
By the way, who was your drummer?
That guy's name was Rex.
Was astounding.
I know, right?
So good.
Damn. Yeah.
But you were like in sync with the band. Even when you went over here, when you went over there, they were with you, the whole thing. You know, one of the things I love about music is the journey that one song can take you on. I felt so many different things as I was watching that. And at the end, when you hit the big no, I was like, yes, that's where I wanted to go. Yes, thank you. And it was just, it was the end of the journey. It was the climax. It was amazing. It was really good. I really liked it.
Thank you.
Yo, what you did tonight, Phil Phillips did tonight, and Joshua, is you guys took these songs and you made them your own. People have sung this song a lot, and I mean, Gwen and Jimmy and Tony gave you good advice. That breakdown with the halftime thing with the drums was sick, dude. You're so current. I mean, I love watching you come up here to see what you're gonna do. Steven's right, you're ready to go, and the drummer is ridiculous. Right. Oh my God, give him props. Yeah. Props.
Colton, ladies and gentlemen. So, you changed up that arrangement. So I think the question on everybody's mind is foil or one step?
Hair's a little different, if you didn't notice. But the arrangement actually came from a band, Quiet Drive. I completely ripped them off. Sorry, guys. I loved it so much that I had to run with it and add a little changes, but I love that version. So hopefully I did it well.
Well, good job tonight. Colton's number is 1-866-IDIS-07. 1-866-436-5707 or text your vote to 5707. Don't vote until the end of the show. Good luck, my friend.
Thank you.
Just after this, the soft and sensitive side of Skylar debuts live on the Idol stage. Be right back. Welcome back to the show. If you want to create your own 80s Idol playlist, don't forget to download all the songs online, including one from a girl who's far, far away from her country roots.
I miss my friends from back home a lot. I miss my family. I miss the cooking.
We're about to eat some summer sausage. It's deer meat with pepper jack cheese in it.
I miss my boiler and my gun so much.
We're in the deer stand, waiting on some deer.
But I'm so happy to be here. I wouldn't trade it. I have plenty of time to go mud riding, but only one time here.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
The producers told me that the mentor was Shalimar from the 80s, and I was like, I don't know who that is. And I walk in, and the whole time I'm sitting there like, this girl looks like Gwen Stefani. Why does she look this much like Gwen Stefani?
Being in the bottom three kind of jolted me a little bit. So I don't really know if I should stick with doing upbeat songs or doing a ballad, or I have Wind Beneath My Wings. I had 9 to 5.
I think 9 to 5 is the way to go.
It's a little bit like a musical. I think you could do that really well.
Working 9 to 5.
She has this really great performance thing about her. So we were like, showcase that. It's too, you know, close to the end to be taking any risks. And then when she sang Wind Beneath My Wings, everybody was shocked, I think, that it sounded that good.
Did you ever?
Awesome.
Wow, that was beautiful. Your voice is, it's like ice cream. It's beautiful.
I've completely flipped. My vote is Wind Beneath My Wings.
I have too. If she brings that emotion out with her personality, it could be a really wow moment this week for her.
It must have been cold there. In my shadow, to never have sunlight on your face. You were content to let me shine that way. You always walked a step behind. So I was the one with all the glory, but you were the one with all the strength. A beautiful face without a name for so long. A beautiful smile to hide her pain. Did you ever know that you're my hero? And everything I would like to be. I can fly higher than an eagle.
Wow, Skylar, wow, wow. Okay, so listen. The song started, it was beautiful. You know, I love the way you look. And I was like, okay, yo, she needs a performance this week. I know she's got that big old voice. And there you go at the end, you showed up. I mean, I think this is your best performance on the show today. Congratulations. Unbelievable. Amazing. Keep that big voice. Be all you can be. You know, I think this girl wants it too. Man.
Yeah, well, that's what I was just gonna say. You know what? You know what you just said to America with that performance, who I don't know if they knew you could sing that way? Do not count me out.
That's right.
Is that a little country twang? Can I say count?
That's right.
You know, you've been doing these country songs, you do that great, that is so who you are, but you just told them that you can sing with the best of everybody who's here, and you can. Amazing!
That's the best song you could have picked for your voice and the end of the night. Yeah. And the beginning of a great career, girl.
Yeah.
That was just so fine.
Nice job. Come on down. So you were in that bottom three, and you thought to yourself, I don't want to be there again.
I said, I don't want to be there again. And I just said, you know what? Let me put just a pretty old dress on and sing a really pretty ballad and just show them something that they really haven't seen yet. I mean, I wanted to show my full range, and I hope that I did tonight.
Well, you certainly accomplished
Yes.
That song from Beaches had Jennifer a little emotional there.
No, did they close? I hope they didn't close up on me.
Oh.
Yes, it did. It really did. It's just one of those songs when you have special people like that in your life, and, you know, it's just one of those beautiful movies, too. It's just a lot of things going through my mind. But because of the way she sang it.
Amazing.
Beautiful.
It really made me feel it.
1-866-IDOL-08. 1-866-436-5708. If you're with AT&T, you can text the word vote to 5708. Or you can vote online at AmericanIdol.com. Skylar, you look very pretty tonight. Good job up there. All right, let's look back at the numbers you need one more time. Roll it.
You will never know.
watching Skylar there and the group tonight. One of these faces is your next American Idol. So, judges, stiff competition at this point. If you were at home watching, how would you vote? Randy?
Man, listen, I think you got to vote now for who do you think can really win this. I mean, there were some great performances tonight. I mean, Skylar came up there at the end. She gave a great shout-out, great performance. I mean, you know, you saw DeAndre was great. I mean, you got some, I mean, you know, of course, Philip and Joshua and Jessica and Colton. And, you know, look, you got to vote for who you think can really win.
Jennifer?
I think you... Okay. I think you got to really vote for the full package. The thing is, we have about a whole bunch of them up there. But that's how you have to, you know, it's the voice, it's the performance, it's the feeling, it's the look, it's how you they make you feel if you like them. All of those things is why people vote, I think, and they should factor in all of those things, not just one thing.
And Stephen, it got tighter as the night went on.
It did. You know, it's a hard era to sing in today's voices. Very, very hard. So, you know, you got to vote for whoever makes you feel good and delivers the whole package, and that's what you got to do.
Let's hear for him one more time. The lines are now officially open and will stay open for at least 2 hours. The race is so close right now. Don't take your favorites for granted. You need to vote to keep them alive and in this competition. Tomorrow night, results plus Kelly Pickler and The Wanted. That action starts at 8, 7 Central. Everybody in, huddle up. Huddle up, let's go. Your local news is next. Who do you love? Good night, America. Thanks for watching. Everybody here.